हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द चैप्टर नंबर 11, द सैम्पलिंग डिजाइन एंड द प्रोसीजर. सो टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द वेरियस टर्मिनोलॉजीज रिलेटेड टू सैम्पलिंग. आफ्टर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मेथड ऑफ सैम्पलिंग. वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट इज नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी, व्हाट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी, एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट मेथड ऑफ द प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट मेथड ऑफ अ नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी सैम्पलिंग. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम टर्मिनोलॉजी और द डेफिनेशंस रिलेटेड टू सैम्पलिंग. द फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस about the population. So first, what is a population? So if we talk about the population, is the aggregate of all the elements sharing some common set of characteristics, which is known as a population. If we take the example of, let's say for example, if my topic is to understand customer, to understand student preference towards student preference towards electronic bikes in Ahmedabad. So in this case, the students of Ahmedabad is my population. If I want to understand the student perception towards the university, so in this case, all the students who are studying or who are associated with the university, this is known as a population. If topic is working woman perception towards ready to eat food, so in this case, the working woman in Ahmedabad is known as a population. So basically, the aggregate of all the elements sharing some common set of characteristics, which is known as a population. If we talk about the census, census means when we are going to take all the element of a population, then it is known as a census. Let's say for example, if we take the example, in company there are the 500 employees there, and company want to understand the employee satisfaction. So in this case, if they are taking opinion from 500 employees, then it is known as a census. For example, if we talk about in one class 200 students are there, and if faculty want to understand the student opinion, and if they will take a opinion of 200 students, then it is known as a census. Meaning of census means when we are going to take all the element into consideration, then it is known as a census. If we talk about, let's say for example, in one GIDC 50 companies are there, and GIDC want to understand the company's opinion. So in this case, if they are taking opinion from 50 companies, means all the companies which is there in GIDC, then it is known as a census survey. If we talk about the sample, sample means we are going to select the few elements from the population. This is known as a sample survey. Generally in management, we prefer to do the sample survey. For example, 200 students are in a class. Out of that, we will select to take an opinion of few students, maybe 20, 30 or the 50. Then it is known as a sample survey. For example, company want to understand working woman preference towards ready to cook food in Ahmedabad city. So basically, if company will take an opinion of 200, 300, 500 working woman, then it is known as a sample. Let's say for example, company is having a 500 employee and company want to understand the employee satisfaction. So out of 500, if company will select a few employee, maybe 550, maybe 100, maybe 200, and will take an opinion of those employees, then it is known as a sample. So basically, if we talk about the sample, it is a subgroup of element of the population selected for participants in the study. If we talk about the sample size, then the number of element to be included in a study. So sample size may be the number of elements. So if I have taken the 100 employee, then the 100 is my sample size. If I have taken the opinion of 200 working women, then it is my sample size. If I have selected 100 students out of 200, then this 100 is my sample size. So basically, the meaning of sample size is the number of elements to be included in a study. This is known as a sample size. So basically, we have discussed the four terminology: population, census, sample and sample size. Again, I will brief it. Population, all the element of aggregate of all the element, which is known as a population. If we will select all the element, then it is known as a sample. If we will select the few element out of the population, then it is known as a sample. And the number of element to be included, then it is known as a sample size. Next, we are going to study the comparison between the sample versus census. Here some criteria which is mentioned. If we talk about the budget, so when we are having a small budget, at that time we can go for the sample survey. When our budget is large, in this case we can go for the census survey. Time availability, if we want to do the sample survey, the time requirement is a short compared to that if we want to do the census survey, because we need to select the more element of the population. Because of that, time required is more if we talk about the census survey. Population size, basically when our population size is large, in this case we can able to go for the sample survey. Let's say for example, if we want to understand the customer preference in Ahmedabad city towards Coke, so maybe our population is 70 to 80 lakh. In this case we cannot able to go for the census. In this case our population is large, so in this case the sample is a more preferable. If we talk about the census, when our sample size is small, in this case we can able to go for the census. Basically, if let's say for example only 50 employees are there in a company, so in this case we can able to go for the census survey. Or maybe company is having only the 20 distributors, so in this case we can able to go for the census survey. Variation in the characteristics, when let's say for example group is a homogeneous, when the variation in the characteristic is less, in this case the sample is more preferable. When the group is a heterogeneous, when the variation in the characteristics is high, in this case the census is a more preferable. Cost of sampling errors, basically we have discussed the two type of error, which is the sampling and the non-sampling. Let's say for example if we talk about the sampling error, the error in a research due to the inappropriate selection of a sample, which is known as a cost of sampling error. So in this case if our cost of sampling error is low, in this case we can go for the sample. If our cost of sampling is high, in this case we can go for the census. Cost of non-sampling errors, cost of non-sampling means the error which is apart from the sampling. Maybe that we can say that the non-respondent error, non-willingness error, cheating error, recording error, these all are which is known as a cost non-sampling error. So when we can say that the cost of non-sampling error is high, in this case we can go for the sample, and when it is low we can go for the census. Nature of the measure, attention to individual cases, because here we are going to select the small samples or the small element from the population, so we can able to pay attention towards the individual elements. When we talk about the sample when we talk about the census, in this case we need to take the opinion from the large number of the respondents, so in this case we cannot able to pay attention towards the individual cases. Next, we are going to discuss about the sampling technique. Basically, two type of sampling technique which is there. First one is a non-probability sampling and second one is a probability sampling technique. First, we are going to discuss what is the meaning of the non-probability sampling, and after that, we will discuss about the probability sampling. And after that, today's session, we are going to discuss the various method of the non-probability sampling. So, first, we talk about the non-probability sampling. So, if we talk about the non-probability, all the element of population do not have an equal chance of selection. This method which is known as a non-probability sampling. Again, I am repeating, all the element of population do not have an equal chance of selection. This is known as a non-probability sampling technique. Let's say for example, if we take the example of a class, in class total students are 200, and out of that, if faculty want to select the 50 students, but let's say for example faculty will select those who are present on the same day, maybe the student whosoever is absent on that day, they will not get a chance of a selection. That's why it is example of a non-probability sampling, because students whosoever is absent in this particular day, they will not get a chance of the selection. So this is example of a non-probability sampling technique. But when we talk about the probability sampling, meaning of probability sampling, all the element of population will get an equal chance of selection. Same example, there just assumed 200 students are there in a class which is known as a population. Out of that, faculty want to select the 50 students and want to take the opinion of 50 students. If faculty will follow the probability sampling, then the faculty will select, faculty will take the attendance sheet. Based upon the attendance sheet, in attendance sheet, the name of all the student which is mentioned, and out of that, they will select randomly, they will select the any 50 students. So here in this case, whether student is absent, whether student is present, all the element will get a equal chance of selection. That's why it is known as a probability sampling technique. So if we talk about non-probability, all the element of population do not get an equal chance of selection. If we talk about the probability, all the element of population will get an equal chance of the selection. If we talk about moving further towards the different method of the non-probability sampling technique, first which is of the convenience sampling, then judgmental, then quota, then the snowball. If we talk about the convenience sampling method, so basically convenience sampling attempts to obtain a sample of convenient elements. So basically if we talk about the convenience sampling, so basically if we talk about sampling methods and what is the importance of the sampling methods, let's say for example if faculty want to select the 50 students out of 200, but those 50 students should be the representative of this 200 students, then we can able to minimize the error in our research. That's why these faculty should use the different method for selecting the samples. If we talk about the convenience sampling, then based upon the faculty convenient, based upon the researcher convenient, if researcher will select the sample, then it is known as a convenient sampling method. Let's say for example, researcher will select the or take a opinion from the people who are easily available. Let's say for example the students, or let's say for example the people who are staying nearby to them, then it is known as a convenience sampling. Based upon the researcher convenience, if researcher will select some sample, then it is known as a convenience sampling. If we talk about the judgmental sampling, if we talk about judgmental sampling, means based upon researcher judgment, based upon the researcher opinion, if researcher will select the sample, then it is known as a judgmental sampling. For example, faculty want to select 50 students out of 200. So based upon that judgment, if faculty will select the 50 students, then it is example of the judgmental sampling. Again, let's say for example, total 500 employees are working in a company. HR want to understand, or they want to understand the employee satisfaction towards the X company, and for that, out of 500, they need to take the opinion of the 60 employee. So if the HR, based upon their judgment, if HR will select the 60 employee out of 500, then it is example of a judgmental sampling. If we talk about the taste marketing, it is a best example of a judgmental sampling. Let's say for example, so many different options which is available, but based upon the researcher or the based upon the marketer's judgment, they will select the one market for the taste marketing, then it is example of a judgmental sampling. Next, we are going to discuss about the quota sampling. So basically, if we talk about the quota sampling, basically it is a two-stage sampling. Here, if we talk about quota sampling, so based upon some characteristics, hold the population which is divided in a different quota. If we talk about the characteristics of the quota, then within quota means within one group, sample should be homogeneous, and between group, the sample should be heterogeneous. Let's say, for example, if we talk about the quota sampling, let's say, for example, you want to understand customer satisfaction towards Coke in Gujarat city. So first, what you need to do, based upon one characteristics, means based upon some location or based upon the geography, we are going to divide the Gujarat into the different groups. Let's say, for example, we have divided Gujarat into the different cities. For example, it is Ahmedabad, one group is Ahmedabad, one group is Baroda, one group is Surat, one group is Rajkot, one group is Anand. So basically one city is a Jamnagar. So these all are the different quotas which is available. So first we are going to talk about quota, means within group, the sample should be homogeneous. Between group, it should be heterogeneous. And in a quota sampling, what we are going to do, based upon researcher convenience, they are going to select few elements from Ahmedabad. They will select few elements from Baroda. They will select few elements from Surat. They will select few elements from the Rajkot. And basically, means they will select few from Ahmedabad also, few from Rajkot also, few elements from Anand also, few elements from the Baroda also. So the samples are the representative of a population. So in this case, it is a two-stage sampling. First, the whole population is divided into the small groups, which is known as a quota. If we talk about the characteristics of the quota, then within group, it should be homogeneous. Between group, it should be heterogeneous. Then out of each and every quota, researcher will select the few element of the population. Then it is known as a quota sampling. Again, we take the example, let's say, for example, in one college is offering the various courses. Let's say, for example, college is offering MBA, college is offering MCA, college is offering engineering, college is offering the pharmacy. So basically, the college students are divided into different quota. First step is divided into different quota. The students of MBA is a one quota or one group. Second is students of MCA, it is a different second group. Third is student of engineering is a third quota. Students of pharmacy, which is of the fourth quota. And after that, based upon the researcher convenience, few MBA students will select. Researcher will select few students from MCA group. Based upon the convenience, researcher will select few students from the engineering group. Based upon the convenience, researcher will select a few students from the pharmacy group. Based upon the convenience, then it is example of the quota sampling method. If we talk about the snowball sampling, then in this case, initial group of respondent is selected usually at random. After being interviewed, this respondent are asked to identify others who belong to the target population of the interest. In this case, the snowball sampling generally it is used where the population is rarely available and researcher do not have an idea about the population. In this case, we can go for the snowball sampling. Basically, if researcher want to do the survey, whosoever is having AIDS, because the researcher do not have an idea and they are not knowing the respondent whosoever is having this particular disease. So what, how they are using this method? Initially, they are identify one or two AIDS patient. They will take a reference from them and they will approach the other patients and they will take the opinion. So basically, it is like a chain. Randomly, first researcher will select one or two respondent. They will take opinion from them, and they will identify the other respondent, and they will take a reference from them, and after that they will identify the other respondent. So this is known as a snowball sampling. Basically, this method is used where the population is rarely available. Let's say, for example, if a researcher want to take the opinion of the Parsi community, so in this case, this community which is rarely available and respondent do not have idea about this. So initially they will identify 2 to 3 respondent. They will take a reference, and after that, based upon the reference, they will identify the other respondent and they will take an opinion from them. Again, they will take a reference from them, identify the other references. So it is like a chain, right? So this is known as a snowball sampling. So in this session, we have discussed the 4 methods of a non-probability sampling. We have discussed, first we have discussed convenience, after that we have discussed judgmental sampling, after that we have discussed quota sampling, and after that we have discussed the snowball sampling. So these all are the 4 methods of the non-probability sampling.